Hass Petroleum was founded in 1996. We came from a family who used to be transporters. They used to transport bulk fuel and other cargoes in the Eastern Central Africa. And we used to transport them all the way to Sudan, Uganda, and DRC. My El Nino came, my brother, young brother, and me met. There was a shortfall of the fuel, especially in Tanzania. And El Nino, you remember, it came suddenly and cut down all the infrastructures and everything and everywhere. And at that time, we were in Kisumu, and we said, okay, there was a lot of demand coming from the lake region. This demand started coming for people asking for fuel because there was no fuel. They were cut off from Dar es Salaam and all the other areas. From Kisumu, when we were loading, and my brother was in Mwanza, so we load, ship it, take it to Espania, the border, cross it, pay the duty, send it to Mwanza, and then bring it. And our resources were very small. At that time, we were not Hass, we were AA Hass. We were linked before to the transportation of this business. And that inspired us and said that, let's look at this thing, it's a big thing. My first station was in Kisumu, and we opened it in Kibuye, and it became a hit. It became one of the big, most beautiful and major stations. We reached a stage that we needed a strategic partner to continue. And some 5 years ago, we said we have to start doing retail networks, and we need to have a target of 200 stations. And as a result, we went around, and we found OTI. Now they've changed to OQ, and it's Oman Trading, which is owned by Oman government. They bought 40% from Hass. Now Hass left it to become a partnership.
Mahmoud Salad is my name. I'm currently the group CEO for Hass Petroleum. So if you talk about the Hass Petroleum brands and product that we deal with, first we are well known for our fuel or refined product that is now the diesel, the petrol, and so on. We're also well known for innovative LPG. Let me not forget the aviation industry, I mean the Jet A1, where we are best known for being one of the biggest companies that enjoy the best market share as far as market like, I mean, airport like JKIA is concerned.
Hass Petroleum is one of our main suppliers of jet fuel. They control about 70% of our Nairobi supply. We've had a relationship with Hass Petroleum now for the last 5 years. Given that fuel forms part of about 20% of our costs, we have to have a reliable partner, and Hass has been that reliable partner. They are always a call away. They are always on time, good quality fuel passed on to us. When you look at the year 2021, our on-time performance was 91%. And a company like Hass contributed towards this. We have always left on time because they are able to fuel on time. And that way, the value proposition that we always give to our customers, that we are a reliable on-time airline, Hass contributes significantly to that promise.
We are well known for this product, and we are happy and proud that this product we are confidently selling in about 9 African countries, just to mention a few: Kenya, Uganda, South Sudan, Tanzania, our customers in Rwanda. Our customers in DRC, especially the mining company, enjoy a very good and efficient service, and without forgetting, you know, markets like Zambia and Somalia.
We targeted countries where they could not reach and where they were afraid to penetrate, and they were not allowed to deal with. So as a result of that, we inspired to go to those areas.
When it comes to the markets we operate, the key driver is first us ensuring that we cover the supply chain. So for example, we have grouped the Kenya, Uganda, and South Sudan as market that we call our Northern Corridor. In that corridor, the port of Mombasa becomes quite crucial in terms of our importation of product. And using our fleet of companies, I mean, we've got trucking companies with over 200 trucks, which supports now the hinterland of Uganda, South Sudan, and so on. Equally, we have what we call our Southern Corridor, where the port of Dar es Salaam becomes crucial. So from the port of Dar es Salaam in Tanzania, we make sure that we receive that product truck using our own fleet of trucks to our hinterland, Rwanda, Zambia, DRC, and so on.
The other milestone which helped us a lot was the terminal depot in Dar es Salaam. Immediately we put up that terminal, putting up a 25 million liter depot. There's a lot of confidence and trust came up, and a lot of companies who are now seeing we're serious people who are being accepted.
When you build that kind of infrastructure, yes, we could effectively compete in the market of Tanzania, but it gave us that opportunity to now go and deliver the best we are known for in markets like DRC, in Zambia, where the government tender has been with us since the year 2016. We've thought about our customer services and how do we get efficiency. Then we realized reliance on third-party subcontracted trucks will not work for us, led to the birth of fleet logistics. We've been one of the leading winners of supplies or tenders in Tanzania. All this capacity to deliver to customers in this kind of frontiers was made possible by this kind of investment that we did in Tanzania.
The company has invested a lot here in Tanzania, including this terminal, retail network, and a fleet of about 125 trucks. We've been serving Tanzania for almost the last 20 years, and this is the gateway to the Southern Corridor. And thanks to the port of Dar es Salaam, where we have these tank farms where we receive products directly from the vessel into our tanks, and we load them on trucks to different destinations. That is for the transit business. Local business, we have a presence in the retail market. We also supply huge accounts on consumer, like the constructions of the famous BRT in Dar es Salaam, which is being constructed by a Chinese company, Sinohydro, who we are proudly supporting or supplying fuel to this project.
We work with Hass. They supply the design for us, for projects. So everything is okay. We are so happy with Hass.
Hass Terminal, which is this facility of 24 million liters, was commissioned in 2011. We have a capacity to expand to 40 million liters. Currently, we are doing a throughput of about 32 to 35 million liters monthly. On a daily basis, we are loading about 60 to 70 trucks, both for our affiliates and for the hospitality clients who are storing their products with us, who have trusted us for the past 11 years that we have been in business.
Hass Petroleum ni kampuni ambayo inatupatia ushirikiano. Tumeona Hass akiendelea kushiriki pia kwenye uagizaji wa mafuta, kwa maana ya kuagiza mafuta yake kupitia mfumo tulioanzisha wa bulk procurement system. Tunaona mafanikio ya Hass Petroleum yakikua zaidi na kufanya biashara kwa ufanisi kwa sababu ya kufuata taratibu za kiudhibiti.
Tumewachagua Hass kwa sababu tunapata huduma nzuri kutoka kwao, tunapata affordable price, tunapata huduma kwa wakati ambayo inatusaidia hata sisi kuendelea kutoa huduma kwa wateja wetu kwa wakati wote.
With the slogan of Hass being servicing new frontiers, we have successfully managed to supply different government entities, different industries in this corridor, and we have played a big role in empowering the economy, because once we are supporting this initiative by government, we are supporting the economy at different levels.
ISO certification on quality and health and safety and so on, for me, was one of the biggest milestones to confirm that we are the best in what we do in this market. It is a mark of quality. It confirms that as a local brand, we are not just competing in giving what everybody else, but we challenge ourselves with the best practices that others have adopted. Today, Hass Petroleum is an employer of choice for over 1,800 employees. When you talk about people, it is the main thing, I think, in Hass Petroleum. Our values has been, how do we attract the best brain in this market into this company? But more importantly, how do we retain them, grow them, nurture them to become, you know, the best in the markets that we operate. Equally, when I'm dealing with customers, again, that aspect of you are dealing with the people comes in, and this has really worked for us. And that ability to just sit down with them openly and discuss the challenges has made a big impact in the businesses that we have developed over the years. We are in about 9 African countries. We are headquartered in Dubai. We are talking about asset base of over $250 million. And we're talking about a retail infrastructure or a retail station of above 150 plus. So from that humble beginning and 2 decades, you know, to where we are, the largest or the biggest, the number one indigenous Kenya-owned oil marketing company in Kenya, I think it's something to be proud of.
And so we're going to the big lake. It looks like Hass is growing and crossing the bridge, eh? But it came a long way. The secret was the people we employed.
We are among the first companies who have introduced non-combustible, or what we call composite cylinders, that are very safe, very light, translucent, meaning you can see the level of the gas.
As a company, we've taken the initiative and the time to ensure that the product that we are delivering to our customers meets the safety standard and actually even goes above what other players are offering in the market. And we've gotten positive feedback from the customers with regard to the features and the benefits that this product has. First of all, we comply with the industry practice in terms of safety, in terms of all the procedures as required by the regulator. That is why we do our filling of our gas here within our plant. Beyond delivering Hass gas cylinder to the customers, we've gone an extra mile in terms of, as a company, to ensure that we innovate and we work closely with our customers in terms of delivering. We are partnering with industry experts in terms of gas piping. We take the product closer to the customer in terms of easy access through the regulation of gas in households. We've also rolled out the auto gas project in our station, such that now those vehicles that have been converted into an LPG can also access our product from our retail outlet, in addition to the fuel that we supply from our retail service stations across the country.
We're also best known for our lubricant products.
The Hass Lubes roadmap started back in 2010, and since then we have diversified into quite a number of products. We have diesel engine oils, we have petrol engine oils, introduced greases, we have introduced industrial lubricants, and not just that, we even went further to sell our products in other countries. Our flagship brand is Atroil, standing for All Trucks Oil. It is a diesel engine oil largely used by main long mileage trucks. We also have a brand of petrol engine oils, which goes by the name Topax, Top Performance Oils. We also have a range of greases depending on the requirement of the vehicle. We have the brake fluids, we have the coolant, basically the full automotive range. On the industrial side, we also have key industrial lubricants, like we have hydraulic oils, we have industrial gear oils for heavy machinery. So we have the full range required for at least automotive and industrial requirements. The experts tested our lubricants independently, and they are happy with the quality of our lubricants and the long mileage that we offer. They are also happy with the fact that we have been consistent on using virgin-based lubricants throughout the production of our lubricants. The experts are also happy with the formulations that we have stuck to consistently all these years to maintain the quality of our lubricants blended.
Oil as an industry is not something where you do like a shop, you open up one place and then you leave it like that. Something which will take you one place will take you to the other place. And you know, you are doing a network, you are doing terminals, you are doing everything, you are doing trading, you are doing all these businesses. As a result of that, you'll find that it keeps on moving. We have already in Zambia, we're looking at going to Malawi, we have already got licenses in Botswana, we've got licenses in South Africa, we have started putting up the grounds now. Sudan was a very difficult country, and with a lot of wars, we built up stations, we had over 8-9 stations. Then we had to close them all again, come back to the city only Juba. And a lot of challenges, you know, up to now, we still work there. We supply the government, we supply the business community and everybody there.
We ventured in South Sudan business after the signing of the peace agreement in the year 2005, heavily setting a footprint in line with our brand vision of servicing new frontiers. Given the volatility nature of South Sudan market, we have not wilted and advanced as the only multinational oil company present with heavy presence in Central Equatorial, Eastern and Western Equatorial. In Central Equatorial, we have 3 stations, the famous Atalabara station, well known for the best service bay in the country. Our intention is to increase the number of retail stations by end of 2023. Our clientele base consists of consumer accounts, resellers, wholesalers,
and retailers. We are major number one or the major suppliers of non-governmental organizations, the like of IOM, WFP, CRS, and MSF. Some of them, we have been trading with them for more than 10 years. In the hotel industry, we are heavily involved in terms of supplying LPG. For example, we are number one supplier, sole supplier for Pyramid Hotel, both LPG and fuel.
I prefer Hass Petroleum because they are really professional. Their equipment they use to deliver the petroleum products is really up to date. Rate, pricing is always competitive, best in the market. And they understand the business also. Sometimes I've seen when the market is closed, the border is closed, they have arranged a small quantity for us, and early morning they have delivered in our tank. That is called going beyond your capacity. Their quality of product is really good. The petroleum, diesel they are supplying to us, perfect.
What makes us successful in this market? We are here first. We have heavily invested in all touch points. We have partnered with government. We have partnered with people of South Sudan. We contribute heavily to corporate social responsibility. We are the only sponsor of Atalabara Football Club.
Atalabara has represented South Sudan in African Championship and in Confederation Cup. Atalabara has gone to Championship almost about 4 or 5 times, and it has gone to Confederation almost also 5 or 2 or 4 times. And Hass has actually contributed very much in developing sports in Atalabara. They provide us with a uniform, training boots. They provide us with almost everything, including when the season for signing players has come, they always participate in signing. Like recently, they signed for us 2 good players.
My name is Mandela Malis. I'm a new player. I signed for Atalabara. I'm a midfielder, Hass Petroleum. I would like to thank you people for this pleasure, time that you have given to us, to support us, to be with us. Everything, we appreciate everything.
South Sudan is a rising market with huge potential. Exploration of crude oil, coupled with the country joining East African Community. We believe the country will be one of the movers and shakers in the region. We want to be the pioneers in the rebuild of South Sudan and the people of South Sudan.
I will personally say we've touched on almost all industries in those markets where we operate. So if you talk about, for example, pick the example of DRC. In DRC, we are best known for the services that we provide to the mining companies, mainly the copper mines in the copper belt of Lubumbashi and so on. When you come to Kenya, the infrastructural development that you see, whether it is the railway line, SGR, the Lamu port, this infrastructure that has supported us, the number one supplier of fuel. So we proudly associated with, you know, the transport infrastructure that you have seen in East Africa. Same case also for major roads that happen in Tanzania and so on. We are the supplier of defense forces here in Kenya. In South Sudan, we've just signed an agreement with the SSPDF, the defense forces in South Sudan. If you talk about power plants in Rwanda, where we've been the suppliers for a number of years, Hass has touched major industries, major sectors, and has been part and pillar of the changes that you've seen in the market where we operate, East and Central Africa.
We help communities, we help a lot, and we take back in terms of schooling and orphanage and helping a drought, foodstuffs, everything, all that we participate and help all the sickly and everybody. We have funds for that which we have allocated, and we normally move on that. My vision is that we continue to capture Africa, continue building networks to make sure that we in every country have infrastructures, stations, terminals, and everything in every country.
If you talk about the journey of Hass and the success stories, what has really worked for us, why we feel probably we are different or the age of our competitors, is having a control of the whole supply chain. So once product is delivered, let's take the example of my deliveries to mining companies in DRC. A customer demands you to deliver this product at a very difficult time. So what does that mean? Once the product is received in Dar es Salaam, I receive in Hass own depot. That gives me an edge in terms of making sure that even if we work overtime, we do to deliver to that customer satisfaction. Once the product is in that depot, what am I loading with? I'm loading with a Hass own Hass control trucks, our trucking company called Fleet Logistics. Now, using Fleet Logistics, using the supply chain, as I mentioned, the depot in Dar es Salaam, I work so hard never to disappoint a customer. This ability to control the supply chain end to end has made us meet and exceed expectation of our customers. In markets like South Sudan and DRC, people shy away. As Hass, we are the number one, we're the leading marketing company, oil marketing company in most of those markets. What this has given us is that loyalty from our customers for supplying and servicing them when many shied away. And I believe when this market open up, it gives me an edge, a head start over any other new entrant into those markets.
During the COVID time, because of our presence in many countries and the lead time, when the oil prices collapsed, we could be able to ship our products to far countries like DRC, Congo, Zambia, Malawi, all these countries, because we have fully fledged companies there who are already ready and stations.
With the Hass kind of mentality, with the team that we have in here, and with the partnership and bond that we developed with our customers over a period, we were able to overcome all that. And today, I think we are proud to say, you know, we had our best last 2-3 years in terms of performance, profitability, and bottom line in almost all the markets we operate. If we were to talk about the future for us as Hass Petroleum Group, I think the focus will be on the two fronts. One, I will say, right next to us is Ethiopia, just on top of us, a market of about 100 million population. And now that we have really serviced the market of Somalia, we have an entity registered but not active in Djibouti, which is the gateway to Ethiopia. Ethiopia is a market that we are very keen. We've grown quite deeply into the south, now we're in Zambia. And if you look at that market, if you look at the map of Africa, most of those supplies, apart from coming from Tanzania, we're also bringing it from Mozambique. So again, a presence in Mozambique and investment of infrastructure in Mozambique, the port of Beira, is something very attractive to me and to the board. And not to forget, of course, also market like Zimbabwe, because right next to the gateway of Mozambique is again Zimbabwe. This is where the focus is. The driver to this is mainly, are we able to cover the supply chain? Are we able to get products closer to those markets, deliver to customers, you know, with the efficiency we are known for? And I believe we've already covered good grounds on the north and also on the south, and that's where the focus will be.
Jambojet, currently, we are a domestic and regional carrier. So Hass is moving to the same space as Jambojet. That is very key to us because Hass is available in quite a number of the markets that we will be flying into.
I just want to thank the people who are supporting us all this time. I want to thank all the consumers, all those who are proud of us and who support us. I want to tell my staff, congratulations, we have reached a milestone. Let's keep up the good work. Let's continue with what we're doing. Let's get, you know, the motivation we have as Hass, as a family. Honestly, we kept that one for long.
In celebration of our 25 years of being Hass Petroleum, a brand that you have trusted as a customer, a brand that you've worked for day and night as an employee of this company, a brand that has been, you know, the biggest contributor of, say, taxes in the markets that we operate. I think my message is, you've believed in us, we believe in you as well. My position and my message is, we will continue to endeavor ourselves to deliver, meet and exceed your expectations that you expect out of us as Hass Petroleum brand, and we are proud to be associated with each and every stakeholders that we've worked for or worked with in these 25 years of our existence.
I want to wish Hass a happy 25th anniversary.
We say thank you to Hass.
Ninawapongeza pia niwashukuru sana.
Happy anniversary of 25th to the Hass Petroleum.
Big congratulations and success of this festival.
And we wish you actually more success.
Happy anniversary.